Hello dear students, welcome to English class. In this video, we are going to learn a new chapter from your Honeycomb textbook, that is chapter 2, Gift of Chapels. The story Gift of Chapels is about the mischievous and simplicity of children's behavior. In this story, we are introduced to four children. They are Ravi, Lali, Meena and Mrudu. The chapter shows innocence and generosity of these children. They are very sensitive and they are very kind to others. Now, dear students, let us read and find out more details about this story.
In the beginning of the chapter, we are introduced to a young girl named Mrudu. The name of the young girl is Mrudu. She is living in Chennai with her Tapi and Tata. Tapi is the Tamil word for grandmother and Tata is the Tamil word for grandfather. So our little Mrudu is living with her grandmother and grandfather. One afternoon, Mrudu went to her aunt Rukmani's house along with her grandmother. She went there to meet her cousins Lali, Ravi and Meena. So what's the name of Mrudu's aunt? Name of Mrudu's aunt is Rukmani. And who all were her cousins? Lali, Ravi and Meena. So one afternoon, Mrudu along with her grandmother went to meet her cousins Lali, Ravi and Meena. Now our Mrudu reached her aunt's house and Rukmani opened the door. Her cousins Ravi and Meena were so excited and happy to see her. And Ravi pulled her into the house. So Mrudu took off her slippers and placed it neatly. At that time, when she was taking off her slippers, she noticed something. She noticed a large old grey slippers covered with dust. But Mrudu didn't get time to even think about whose slippers they were because Ravi dragged her to the backyard. Ravi, Mrudu and Meena are now in their backyard. There was a bitterberry bush in their backyard and behind this bitterberry bush there was a torn football, an old torn football filled with sand. And inside that football, there was something. It was a small kitten and the kitten was drinking milk from the coconut shell. Meena informed Mrudu that they have found the kitten outside their house in the morning. But they must keep it as a secret. Otherwise, the grandmother will leave their house immediately. So, it was a secret. What was the secret of Ravi and Meena? Yes, they are taking care of a small kitten. That was the secret. And nobody in the family knows about it. Their grandmother doesn't like all these things. So if she comes to know about this, she will immediately leave their home. So that is why Ravi and Meena are keeping it as a secret. Actually, elders are always advising children to be kind towards animals. But when the children are doing so, here when the children are taking care of an orphaned cat, the elders are screaming at them. Elders doesn't like it. So, Ravi was so upset about it. Now, Ravi is explaining to Mrudu how hard it is to get a little milk from kitchen for the small kitten. Nobody in the family knows about the kitten. But poor little kitten is very hungry. It is a baby, right? So, it needs milk. But how to get milk from kitchen without being noticed by the elders? It is a hard task. Ravi anyway decided to take milk. But his grandmother was suspicious while he was taking milk from kitchen. He had to drink more than half of the milk to make her believe that it was for him. Ravi told to Mrudu that they have named the kitten as Mahendran. Mrudu loved the name because it sounded like a real name, Mahendran. It's a powerful name, right? Ravi further added that its complete name was Mahendra Verma Pallava Punai and in short MP Punai. So what's the name of the kitten? Mahendra Verma Pallava Punai and in short you can call him as MP Punai. Ravi is now describing about his kitten. He told that his kitten was a fine breed cat. He also added that his kitten is a close relative of lion family, like the one that Pallava kings used in their emblem. A lion was the emblem of Pallava dynasty. And now our Ravi is telling that his kitten is a close relative of that lion. Mridu laughed at this. But Ravi is going on making stories and stories about his kitten. Ravi further explained that on his school trip to Mahabalipuram, he had seen statue of a lion and he firmly believes that it was the ancestor of his kitten. He proudly announced that his small kitten is a descendant of Mahabalipuram Rishi cat. Now he is telling that cats were worshipped in ancient Egypt. And he also told about the ancient Egyptian cat goddess. And now Ravi is again making stories. He told that one of the descendants of this Egyptian cat goddess hid himself in a Pallava ship and reached Mahabalipuram. And the Rishi cat was a descendant of this cat that came from Egypt. And our Mahendran, the little kitten, was a descendant of this Rishi cat. This was a story made by our Ravi. Now I will explain once more the story made by Ravi. Listen, in ancient Egypt, cats were worshipped. They had cat goddess. And one of the descendants of this cat goddess hid himself in a Pallava ship and reached Mahabalipuram. The descendant of this cat who came to Mahabalipuram is called as Mahabalipuram Rishi cat. And our Mahendran is a descendant of this Rishi cat. So according to Ravi's story, the little kitten Mahendran is a close relative of Egyptian cat goddess. This was a story made by our Ravi about the little kitten Mahendran.
So dear students, I hope you understood this part of the chapter. Thank you for watching.